Hello students, here some important or key pests infesting major fruit crops. Among them, this is a banana which is get infested by banana rhizome weevil. Banana rhizome weevil, its scientific name is Cosmopolite sordidis, its family Curculionidae and order Coleoptera. We can identify the insects belong to Curculionidae, and the typical character of this order is typical character of this family Curculionidae is having a snout or elongated projection at their mouth, which generally used to make the depressions to deposit their ovaries to deposit their eggs. So this pest is distributed in India, and it is the serious pest of banana. It is known to attack on cocoa. The adult is medium sized and which can measure about 10 to 13 millimeter in length, which is stout brown in color initially and later turns to the black in few days. We can see the longitudinal markings on their elytra very easily. This is a key identification mark of this pest. The adult also tunnels within the stem, feeding on internal tissues during night. The white elongated oval eggs are laid singly in small pits made into the pseudo stem. The eggs are laid by with the help of such snout by making a depression, and the eggs are laid inside that pseudo stem near the ground. The eggs are elongated oval in shape, white in colored, and which can measure about 2 to 3 millimeter long. The eggs are get hatched within 5 to 8 days. The grub is dwarf, stumpy and apodous, we can say legless, and creamy in color, creamy white in color, having a red colored head and having a wrinkled body. Means most of the apodous larvae having a wrinkled body. The wrinkles or the segments are get fused with each other, and they use that wrinkles to move ahead or to take back them. The grub tunnel into the rhizome, which is roughly circular and increases in size with the growth of the grub. Rhizome become riddled with tunnels. The leaves turn yellow and become dry. The tissue at edge of the tunnel turns brown and get rotted. The grub also bores into the pseudo stem even up to 2 to 3 inches. Due to the damage, the banana plant may break down during the strong winds. We can see the blackened mass of rotted tissues, in which sometimes we can found the grub of rhizome weevil. The plants may show premature withering. Withering symptoms are like yellowing and drying. The leaves become scarce and the fruits become undersized. Very few suckers emerged out around the main pseudo stem. So the larval period or that grub period lasts for 14 to 21 days, and pupation takes place in an oval chamber prepared just beneath the surface of the sucker. Pupation is for 5 to 6 days. So this is a prior information or important events of their life cycle and their nature of damage. Now here are some management practices to control this pest. We can control this pest by obtaining suckers from healthy fields for planting. Clean cultivation and sanitation in the orchard can avoid the attack of rhizome weevil. Dipping the suckers prior to the plantation, dipping the suckers into the methylnematon at the rate 0.1% solution. Avoid returning, and if the plot is get infected, we can avoid the returning, and we can change the field every year. Dusting the pit with carbaryl at the time of planting with the help of 10% carbaryl dust or 250 gram of neem cake into the pit, uprooting and destroying of affected pseudostem and a rhizome in which grubs are present. Applying contact insecticide during July to September, since the attack is more in that season, at July to September at fortnight intervals to prevent the attack. We can temporarily support to the plant which is get attacked by rhizome weevil. Ground application or soil application of 4-8-10 g, 10 gram per plant. Spraying the pseudostem or by drenching around the base of tree trunk with chlorpyrifos 2 ml per liter of water can sufficiently kill this pest. Now the another important pest infesting banana is banana aphid. Its scientific name is Pantalonia nigronervosa. It belongs to family Hemiptera, Aphididae and order Hemiptera. These aphids, adult aphids, are brownish with black vein in the wings. See, these are the black veins present on the forewings or their wings. It lives in colonies within the leaf axil or on the tender leaves at the base of the leaf. A single female produces 35 to 50 nymphs during its lifespan. This aphid is known for parthenogenetic reproduction, and because of that it directly give birth to the young ones, and about 35 to 50 nymphs are laid from the body. The nymphal stage is for 27 to 37 days. There are 4 instars, nymphal instars, and each instar is completed in 2 to 3 days. In 30 to 40 overlapping generations are seen in a year. Since there are only 2 stages, the life cycle is completed rapidly. High humidity and moderate temperature are conducive for the pupation, for population increase. The nymph and adult suck the sap from plant parts, and in case of severe infestation, the progressive leaf is become dwarfen. Leaf curling is seen on the leaves. Fruit bunches become small or undersized, and fruits are get distorted. These aphids also act as a persistent vector of bunchy top of banana. Remember, this could be asked in examination. This pest is known to transmit bunchy top disease. Bunchy top disease in banana. This could be asked for objectives. To control this pest, it is recommended to use a resistant variety like Musa AAB, which is resistant against aphid, and thus it has become resistant against bunchy top. Application of methyl dimeton 2 ml per liter of water with or dimethoate 2 ml of per liter of water or monocrotophos 5 ml per liter of water effectively control the banana aphid. Now, a few important pests infesting coconut, and among them, this is the one: black-headed caterpillar, Opicinia arenosilla. It belongs to family Xylorhynchidae and order Lepidoptera. It is also one more family is there, which is named for Opicinia species, is Cryptophacidae. This is the another family mentioned in some books for black-headed caterpillar, it belongs to order Lepidoptera. This pest, black-headed caterpillar, is most destructive or important pest infesting coconut in India and in Sri Lanka. It occurs more commonly among the west and east coast regions of India. It has been observed infesting coconut in some inland regions of Karnataka and in Tamil Nadu. Adult is grayish white moth measuring 10 to 15 millimeter long with wing without wing expansion and 20 to 25 millimeter in wing expansion across outstretched wings. The moth is straw to ash color or gray in color, medium sized with uniform pale white upper wings. The female moth lays about 130 creamy white scale like eggs in batches along the underside of leaflet, generally near the old larval galleries. Eggs get hatched in 4 to 5 days. Caterpillar is light green in color with a red brown strips as shown in image. This caterpillar is feed gregariously on the surface of leaf tissues and leaflets. It scraps over the green portion or upper portion of leaf and it remains only the lower surface of leaf. The leaflets get reduced and become peppery. The larvae construct the galleries of silk and frass. Frass means that it's excreta and lives in that feeds. The attacked leaflets turn brown in color and get dries up. The tip side part is get attacked more. The production of nuts get adversely affected since photosynthetic activities are get reduced because of feeding on leaflets. The front become unsuitable for thatching and for other purposes. The damage is more during hot months like during April and June, and it is less in rainy season. We can observe the folded leaflets with silken galleries and frass. We can also observe large scale drying of leaflets. In severe cases, in severe attack, the whole plantation presenting a burnt appearance from the distance or from the top. The larva, the grown-up or final instar larva, measures about 15 millimeter long. Larval period lasts for 14 days, and the larva pupates inside the gallery is made on the leaves. Adult get immersed out after 14 days. And it can complete the life cycle within 45 to 65 days. Since it feeds on the leaves, it is very much difficult to control. Due to hidden nature of caterpillar and height of the plant, chemical control measures are often inadequate. So recommended practices are clipping and destroying the infected portion. A host of parasites attack different stages of the pest. For obtaining effective control, scheduled release of combination of these few important parasitoids the releases, there may be multiple releases. First release may be after the infestation, second after fortnight of first release, third a month later, and the fourth fortnight after the third. So the recommended parasitoid for control of this pest is Goniosus nephantidis. Please remember the name Goniosus. This is an larval parasitoid recommended to control black-headed caterpillar. There are many more like Trichogramma chulonis among the egg parasitoid. Then Cotacea species or Braconids or Ilamus. These are important parasitoids, egg and larval parasitoids recommended to control this black-headed caterpillar. Among them, few are naturally occurring, and the parasitoid like Goniosus can be released artificially according to the stage of the plant. Bacteria like Serratia or Bacillus thuringiensis can cause severe loss, severe disease into the larvae and sufficiently kill this black-headed caterpillar. The predatory beetle like carabid beetle also known to kill the larvae. As a part of chemical control, the practice is different and it is called as root feeding technique. A dark brown colored root is selected for root administration of monocrotophos or chlorpyrifos 20C to the trees. The root is given a small slant cut. That cutted end of the root is kept into the polythene bag containing 10 ml of monocrotophos mixed in a 10 ml of water. For plants having 15 feet height, 15 feet or more height, allow the root to absorb chemical for 24 to 48 days. If the root does not absorb the chemical, change the root and select the another root and continue the treatment till the insecticide is get absorbed or taken by the roots. So before, important note is that before administering the chemical, the mature nut should be harvested, and after root administration there should be a gap of at least 45 days to harvest the further nuts. So this is important note prior to control or root administration with chemical insecticide. Another pest is rhinoceros beetle. Its scientific name is Oryctes rhinoceros, and it belongs to family Scarabidae, order Coleoptera. It is widely distributed in Asia, Australia and Pacific Islands. And it is reported from all regions where coconut is grown. It also attacks coconut, oil palm, date palm, sugarcane, banana, pineapple, papaya and many other crops. Here we can see the adult is stout beetle measuring about 35 to 50 millimeter in length. It is a shiny black or sometimes reddish brown in color, and it possess a hair, a dense hairing on the ventral surfaces. We can see a face of beetle has a pointed horn. The horn is elongated and this is a key identification mark of this beetle. This cephalic horn is longer in male and shorter in females. These are diagnostic features of male and female. Adult lives more than 200 days under favorable conditions. Beetles are attracted towards light. See, we can use this character of beetle to control them properly. The beetles injures the tree. See, the damaging stage of this pest is only beetles. The beetle injures the tree by boring into the central shoot, spathe and petioles. The boring beetle chews the internal tissues and after ingesting the juicy part, throws out the fibrous part, which is indicative of the presence of beetle into the crown. The injuries of beetle clearly seen on the leaves, a series of holes on the front. When leaf is get opened out and fan like cut in, means we can observe the V notches, means only few part is get cutted out. This part in such marks are observed on the plant. Such V markings can be seen on the leaves, and with the help of this we can identify the attack. Typical V-shaped clipping cuts on mature leaves in partly damaged grounds. death of central growing primordium of both young and older plants in severe attack. It also known to damage the palm after more often becoming infected by fungal rots. So this pest lay their eggs into the decomposing material, and the eggs get hatched within 4 to 14 days. After getting hatched, the grubs start to feed on decomposing material or manure pit. Inside the manure pit or organic matter, decaying organic matter, since it belongs to Scarabidae, the typical C-shaped grub can be seen into the manure pits. It get pupated inside the manure pit, and adults are get immersed, and they get aggregated towards the primordium or to the shoots of coconut trees. To control this pest, periodically examine the breeding places and destruction of eggs, grubs and pupae by raking and turning up the manure pits. So this is a key important practice to control this pest, treating breeding places with carbaryl 50 WP at the rate 3 gram per liter of water, or carbaryl 10% dust at least once in 3 months. We can apply during January, April, July and August. Crownless tree and dead tree should be cut and dried to avoid breeding of the pest. Extraction of beetle with a barbed iron hook, it is also called as probing method, and fill up the holes with sand with linden dust in equal proportion to prevent further attack, or by filling the hole with Savidol 8% granule at the rate 25 grams per plant, providing the poisoned breeding traps made out of rotting mustard and castor cake, or dung mixed with a linden to attract and kill the beetles. There are few beetles like Santalus parallelus is a predaceous against egg and grub stages in the manure pit. The green muscarding fungus Metarhizium anisopli. In fact, all stages except egg can be get attacked and diseased with this Metarhizium anisopli, and we can apply this at on the plant and also on the inside the manure pit. The bacteria Serratia and Pseudomonas attack the third instar grub Nematode DD136, which is considered as Neoplactena corpocapsi, and in association with Acromobacter parasitize the grubs, and the final important is we can release the baculoviruses as a part of important biocontrol measure to control these beetles. The another important pest infesting coconut is red palm weevil. It is Rhynchophorus ferruginis. It is belongs to Curculidae and order Coleoptera. It is again distributed in all coconut growing countries. In India, it occurs in all coconut growing tracts. It also infects the oil palm, date, and sago, and other species of palm. Adult is reddish brown, as we can see in the image, and which measures about 35 millimeter in length. It has 6 dark color spots on the thorax, 6 dark black color spots on the thorax, and the male in the male the snout has tuft of hair. The snout is present with a tuft of hair, and in female it is elongated and strong, which is generally used for making the depressions. It can lay 276 eggs. The eggs are laid in small holes scooped by the weevil female on the soft regions of young palm of 7 years age. The grown-up tree, the eggs are laid only in the cuts or wounds which are present on the soft tree trunk. The plant sap oozing out of the wounds and cuts attract the weevil for oviposition. Actually, this plant prefers to ovipose it in the exposed plant tissues, wherever there are attacked parts of rhinoceros beetle, or somewhere the crown rot or leaf rot or disease somewhere. These weevils prefer such places to deposit their eggs. After hatching from egg, grub tunnels inside and lives in any part of young palm. But it is usually prefers to concentrate at or near the growing point of the tree, which is usually older than 5 years. A trunk may harbor 40 to 50 grubs at a time in one trunk. The grub feeds within the stem in large numbers, making tunnels. The grub hatched from eggs which are laid in the crown, and it enter into the growing point of the crown and causes yellowing and wilting of leaves on the leaves and on the middle whorls. The presence of circular hole on the stem with brownish black viscous fluid oozing out from the hole, longitudinal splitting of leaf bases, and presence of coconut and adult weevils achieved up fibrous in leaf axis or at the base of palm. The sound of feeding by the grub can be heard by keeping ear on the tree trunk in the silence. Larval period can ranges from 36 to 78 days. The full grown grub, which is stout, fleshy, apodous means legless, construct the oval cocoon with the fibrous material on the internal tissues and pupate within such fibrous cocoons. The adult female lives for 76 days and the male for 133 days. This weevil can multiply in young coconut plantation, especially in those close to the forest areas, and the damage is to extend for 5 to 10% in young plantation. We can control this pest by important practices like disposal of fallen trunk, tree stumps, dying and dead plants due to lightning or bud rot, avoiding the wounds or mechanical injuries, and stripping of leaves. We can avoid the damage to roots and stem during cultural operation. Removal of rhinoceros beetle from the hole using the iron wire or with the help of probing method. And we can apply the neem cake 100 gram with 100 gram of sand to prevent weevil. Arrange the bucket traps, pheromone traps, at 1 to 1.5 meter height on the tree trunk to attract the pest, and weevils can get collected in the bucket. The affected plant cuts scraped off or a cotton swab can be sprayed over such wounds. The cotton swab should be treated with insecticide. Release the sterile male to compete with the normal males as a part of sterile insect technique to reduce the further progeny. The insect ear wing is known to feed on the eggs and grub. Root feeding with monocrotophos which is applied to control Rhinoceros beetle. Root feeding treatment with monocrotophos can control this pest. The another pest is eriophyte mite. Eriophytes, it belongs to Eriophyidae and order Acarina family Eriophyidae. It is a major threat of coconut since it directly infests on the nuts. It makes the triangular pale or yellow patches close to the perianth initially at the level of perianth, which turns into the brown patches on the nuts. Shedding of buttons, using the gummy exudation from affected, we can see the gummy exudations from the affected plant parts, malformed nuts, and we can see the hardened part, which we can see the cracks on the nuts. This pest can be controlled with application of urea 1.3 kilogram, superphosphate 2 kilogram, and muriate of potash 3.5 kilogram to the palm per year. Application of neem cake 5 kg and organic manure 50 kg per palm per year. Grow intercrops like banana, cocoa, turmeric, and vegetables which are in the rich soil, and shelter belts with casuarina all around the coconut garden to minimize this pest. Spraying twice at weekly interval on buttons and on the developing nuts, or on the bunches with wettable sulfur or profenophos, methyldemeton, trisophos, or kelthen, like kelthen means dicofol, or propargite like omite. We can also apply azadirachtin 10,000 ppm on the fruit bunches, or root feeding thrice a year with azadirachtin 10,000 ppm at the rate 10 ml in 10 ml of water. So these are important pests infesting coconut and banana. Thank you.